Well, you take a look here behind me. You see the extent of the damage of this building. The entire one half of the third floor is gone, and the officials here have deemed the building uninhabitable. But at this point, people are being allowed back in to retrieve their belongings.
Residents of the Wallingford apartments in Chester were allowed back in this afternoon and into their fire, smoke, and water damaged units to sift through what was left. They carried out flat screen TVs, a boxed dinette set, children's toys, and garbage bags full of wet clothing.
Look, it's just everything you grab is bad. It's done. It's gone.
This is cell phone video of that fire. It broke out just after 1 o'clock this morning. And as you can see, an entire section of the building was engulfed in flames. Investigators say it started in apartment number 19.
I'm not sure what time it was. I just heard the alarms going off.
Aisha Lewis was in apartment 19, alone, asleep.
Oh God, it was horrible. All I could remember was all this black smoke. And so I got down and start crawling, and I grabbed my pants and my pocketbook and shoes and grabbed the phone, and they was like, knock on people's door and tell them to get out.
12 units were destroyed. A dozen others were damaged by water or smoke. 55 people are now homeless.
Everything that we worked for, we just bought furniture. Everything that we had is in there right now.
Neighbors consoled one another, having lost, in some cases, everything but their lives.
I was just panicking, but I was glad I got my girls out and we were safe and sound.
Okay, you're looking live at the third floor. This is where the firefighter fell through to the second floor. We are told he got a little banged up, but he's okay and he's back home right now. Now, as for the cause of this fire, it is still under investigation. Live in Chester, Byron Scott, NBC 10 News.